Time for 5 minute deck tech, and this time around it's a Golos list that is focused on the card Kaboom, which is spelt with an exclamation point. I didn't know this card existed. I didn't know this deck was even a thing that you could build, but oh my goodness me, check this out. This deck is filled with high converted mana cost cards, and then cards like Kaboom, which do a lot of damage based on the converted mana cost of the cards you play in your deck. Dustin sent in a list that has an average converted mana cost of 7.82, which is a very high, and will mean that you are burning your opponents, burning their creatures, their planeswalkers, everything down to the ground with cards like Kaboom and Kaboom analogs, in addition to massive, big, huge, enormous, expensive spells like Draco. Let's get to it and have a look at what this list is all about. Starting with the Ram Suite, a smaller Ram Suite in this list because we are playing Karuga as a companion, so no cards like Rampant Growth, no Farseek, but there are still cards that have a very high converted mana cost while also juicing up your mana. I'm talking about things like Beanstalk Giant, Spring to Mind, even Shafet Monitor. It is a bit cheaper, but I mean, only 6 mana, it's quite cheap, but still a pretty good hit off of Kaboom, but still a way to make sure you're hitting your land drops in the early game. And of course there is the Commander Golos, which is, you know, as a 5 mana Rampant Growth, not too bad itself. My favorite ramp spell in the deck, however, is definitely Recross the Paths. If you've not seen this, it's a weird Rampant Growth type card that costs 3 mana, but it also has Clash. And given that your deck has, again, an average converted mana cost of a 7.2, you will get to cast this card a lot of times, I would imagine, in the average game. Anyway, we're not just ramping, we do of course need to survive long enough to cast some of these enormous big spells, and for that we need sweepers. And when we're looking for cards that have very high converted mana cost, there are some perfect options. None of this bloody Wrath of God, Day of Judgment, efficient cards like that. No, we're looking at stuff like Blasphemous Act, which often will just, you know, cost 1 mana, but that's not the point, it's a 9 drop. Things like Find Finality, because of the way that split cards work, this means that it's actually considered an 8 drop when seen like cards like Kaboom. And there are other 8 drop sweepers too, Undo Inversion, which can be played as a land. But one thing that's really important in any deck that's looking to play a lot of high CMC cards is to include a whole lot of cyclers to make sure you're not falling behind in the early turns, making sure you've got something to do with your mana as the game opens. And Akroma's Vengeance is a perfect example of a card that's very, very useful on turn 6 to blow up the entire world, or later of course, but still make sure that you can keep those clunky hands that's filled with, you know, 6, 7, 8, 9 drops even perhaps. So it's a great inclusion in this list because of that flexibility, and it is far from the only cycler in the deck. Of course, there are so many enormous, expensive, clunky, high CMC cyclers here that can do things like search up lands in the case of Noble Templar, or ramp your mana in the case of Elvish Aberration. Eternal Dragon can continue to provide you value as the game goes along. And then Grozoth, while it doesn't cycle, it transmutes into other 9 drops. And I mean, normally transmuting into other 9 drops isn't something you're hugely interested in, but I can tell you what, there are certainly some cards you want to search up with Grozoth, and it's a very, very useful card, not only as a transmuter, but also as a target for Eerie Ultimatum. In addition to all the other cards you're going to be cycling away, you can cycle through them all, fill up your graveyard, and if you ever draw the Eerie Ultimatum, bring them all back. It's like a juiced up version of Living End from Modern. We've seen already that flexibility with cards like cycling, cards that can be cast for, you know, a lot of mana or a little bit of mana, are very important in this deck, and you'll see that a lot of the high converted mana cost cards in this deck do come with steep inbuilt discounts. I'm talking about cards like Primeval Protector, cards like Emrakul, The Promised End. These have a converted mana cost of, you know, 11, 12, 13, whatever, but don't often cost that when you cast them. And it's not just creatures. There's Dig Through Time with Delve, can cost 2, but will still be seen as an 8 drop by the Kabooms. And then something like Rags to Riches, which is actually an 11 drop anywhere but the stack, which is not too bad when you get to the suite of cards I'm going to show you in a second. But coming back to those cyclers and some of the creatures, that, I mean, very high impact creatures in this list, and a lot of them do end up in the graveyard. So we've even got the Cauldron of Eternity, another ridiculously overcosted card that doesn't actually ever cost what's printed on it, and a great way to bring back some of those big idiots that you've cycled away earlier. But I've spent the whole video teasing these Kabooms. Let's actually talk about what you can put these high converted mana cost cards to use to do. Kaboom and cards like it rely on having a high converted mana cost to do an enormous amount of damage to your opponents or their creatures, and there are so many, you're not going to believe how many different ways there are to make use of this mechanic. There is of course the classic Kaboom. It's been printed on planeswalkers like Sorin Grim Nemesis, it's been printed on creatures like Spellbound Dragon, and rounding out our Wooburg approach to this effect, it's also on Vengeful Rebirth, so you've got this effect in every single color. But the party don't stop there, let me tell you that. After resolving your Baneful Omen, you can just sit back and relax while it does all the work for you, never have to cast another spell. There's Heretic's Punishment. Continue to mill cards off the top of your library, bring it back with the Cauldron, bring it back with the Ultimatum. There's Soulfire Eruption, the most powerful version of Kaboom that is ever been printed, a card that will absolutely ruin your opponent's day, but my very favourite, Time Sifter. And with an average converted mana cost of 7.82, this deck is the odds-on favourite to take all of the turns for the rest of the game. Thank you so much, Dusty, for sending in this list. It really has been incredible to get across what really has been one of the silliest and sweetest lists I've ever seen. If you want to do the same thing as Dustin, please do send in your lists to me on Twitter, at Riley Knight, without any vowels. You can see it on the screen there. And maybe I'll feature one of your decks in an upcoming video. But that is that for this 5-Minute Deck Tech. Thanks for hanging out with me. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you next time.